We gotta call Meryl. We got her number. It's on the back of a box.
Get that bitch on the phone!
It was written on a bathroom wall. For a good time. Call 140.15.
P.S. Check out the ass.
You're the colonel's niece, Meryl, right?
No.
She'll be, you know, disguised. Exactly, so you're specifically gonna have to look for that butt.
Don't accidentally call a soldier for a good time. It'll be really awkward.
Well, oh god, this is 140.151. Oh no!
Oh, how embarrassing! Oh no!
Oh, I'm sorry.
We go way back.
Since I've called you already, I mean, I... Not
important. Are you busy, or...?
Are you doing anything? I mean, I already did the effort to call you. I mean, it's the wrong number, but I mean, if you're up for it... You? I'm willing to experiment.
Well, I've only been pacing back and forth in this one room for a long while, so, Yeah, I'm not doing anything.
I got, you know, a lot of free time.
And really bad peripheral vision. It's not like I'm gonna...
Yeah. No, I mean, it's not like they're gonna see my Craigslist ads. I like being snuck up on. Like, I wear okay, Snake, I wear horse blinders on purpose.
You'll land back on them once you meet.
I just really want somebody to sneak up on me.
Oh, I don't okay. That.
Doesn't matter what you do, just sneak up on me and spook me.
Snake can do that.
You can snap my neck, you can throw me over your shoulder, you can
Is there like a safe word for this, or?
So what's the deal then? I think it's the alert noise.
What if the safe word were
I think that's too late. That's too late.
Oh shit, I thought that was the President Baker, right after. That's why they stopped moving every time.
Okay. Yeah. It's not a safe word. I don't think it's just a nuclear weapon. It's help, I'm dying.
Boy, oh sound. Boy, it's just like that.
Whoops. Nobody told you
anything. Oops.
Okay. You see, this place isn't really for disposing.
Man, using the alert noise is a safe word. Brink! Just have a big red button like on your nightstand or something. Brink!
Scares the shit out of the other person.
The alert sound still makes me jump.
I used to have it as my text message noise, and it used to like scare the shit out of me every time.
I know, like
I had to change it because it was giving me like heart palpitations. It's like freaking out.
I have heart problems from playing Metal Gear and getting caught too much. Why just this? Like, I've played Metal Gear a ton, and that sound still makes me jump out of my seat sometimes. That's what I
heard anyway. Scarier than anything I've seen in Silent Hill, at least. Like, nothing consistently scares me more than that sound. Sorry, I'm not sure. I was captured. Like, hearing screaming monsters and rusty metal and shit like that, I don't care. It's boring. That's right. Amazing. Fucking exclamation point. Scares the shit out of me.
Some really terrifying punctuation. Baker, huh?
I can't write anymore. He's dead. At all. Because the post-traumatic stress of it. Same as the DARPA. I'm just worried I'm gonna run into one of those.
Can't even write a period because it's just... Can't even write a period because it's just the beginning of an exclamation point. Well, I don't believe in
coincidences. Something funny's going on.
Something funny. Sounds like it. But I have
no idea what. Me neither. Yet. Do you know the person who designed Metal Gear?
You mean Dr. Emmerich?
Yes. Is he still alive?
Probably. He should be in the research lab in the second floor basement of the nuclear warhead second storage floor building to the north.
Basement.
Second
the
floor up basement. Down.
Yeah, that's where.
Gotta go to the up down, Snake.
I think they're forcing him to work on the nuclear launching program.
It's a floor in between.
Can't they just say sub-basement 2?
Yeah, that seemed like it'd make more sense. Or like, basement 2. How about just basement 2? Not second floor basement. The basement of the second floor?
That sounds like it would be like the little space between the first floor and the second floor. Is the basement of the second floor. It's only a couple inches. But he's in there.
Well, the doctor's really small. He's a tiny man.
Very
really
skinny.
Tiny.
He doesn't work out.
He likes very small places, and also damp areas. Don't store your bread near him.
He's like every anime nerd. I want you to hide somewhere. He likes cold, dark, damp places. Oh yes,
you
are.
You pause for just 1 second in front of your enemy, and it's all over. Good luck doesn't last forever.
The face.
Time to bring in the emotional music here.
When I thought about my bullets tearing through those soldiers' bodies, I hesitated.
It's like a
shooting at targets and shooting at living, breathing people are different.
God, I can't remember because they like didn't make this song for this game.
Oh,
really? I forget the artist, but I think she's like Norwegian or something. I really can't remember.
You want to quit?
But
I can't quit.
Allow myself. This is just one of her albums from like around then or something.
Weird.
And I guess Kojima just heard it and is like, well, I gotta have that in my game.
Unfortunately.
Since that's kind of what Kojima does.
I didn't know people came out with like opera albums these days because it's not like the 1300s.
That's not really opera.
I don't know stuff about music basically.
It's a terrorist action.
You're just a little jumpy from the combat high. The adrenaline in your bloodstream is starting to thin out. Just take it easy.
But I learned all about combat high at the academy.
We'll talk about it later. For now, just think about keeping yourself alive.
Oh no, the call has dropped. Damn it. Damn it.
Okay.
Is the video still going for you?
Yeah, everything's still going.
Okay, we're still recording.
What?
You're a real bastard.
We're still recording, right?
Yes.
You're still recording? Okay, we're still going.
You're just
kinda
like, going out there.
It looks like you were
That's weird. Maybe your internet's doing something weird. Dual commentary.
Yes.
We'll link up after I grab the.
All right, you're gonna have to go flush your DNS, and then you're gonna have to go into the the other config. We gotta fix the internet here.
Shit.
We're gonna do tech support live in this LP. All right.
After I open up the cargo door, I'll contact you.
Can't believe this thread isn't gold.
It's a 4.9. That's practically gold. Well, we just talked to her in the moldy bathroom. That's a good place to have an emotional man to woman talk.
In the bathroom.
Excuse me, not man to woman, a soldier to soldier talk. What the heck is a soldier? I don't know, but let's do some squats. Well, time to go up to the first floor. First floor attic basement.
There isn't even a second floor. Where is the second floor basement?
Meryl.
Snake, I unlocked the cargo door for
you.
Thanks.
Aww.
Where are you?
Nicely.
Where I can see ya.
Don't move.
Where I can see ya.
Don't worry, I'm disguised in this
beep boop snake.
You won't be for long.
I like the foosh, like ninja sound effect that plays when she puts her mask on.
It should have been a jet noise. All I'm saying.
The cargo door is like an airlock. It's equipped with infrared sensors. Be careful. If an intruder is sensed, gas is released.
Gas.
Okay, so we'll meet at the nuclear warhead storage building.
Wait, you said you'd stay put and be a good girl.
I changed my mind.
She's bad girl, Snake.
That's when things always turn sour.
Maybe Snake likes bad girls.
You read the bathroom wall. I thought you knew this already.
I know.
I get my hands dirty.
She's a dirty bad girl.
You read
dirty
back
hands.
The case.
See you there.
It's because all the bathrooms are cheesy and moldy. Half the walls in this game look like they're moldy cheese, like blue cheese.
State-of-the-art graphics.
State-of-the-art! It's not that bad for a PS1 game. It's one of the better looking PS1 games. Its style keeps it from looking, like, crappy.
Mm-hmm.
It just looks older. Oh, hey, there's a sleeping man. Let's go snap his neck.
It takes a lot of skill to sleep standing up.
I know,
you
damn.
Must have excellent balance.
Oh, and Twin Snake, so you can hold people up. Come on, do a little dance. Come on. Okay, I'm just gonna put my gun in your mouth, alright? Or your eyeball.
See, does he know the safe word? Are you supposed to put the gun in his mouth? Does he like that?
Well, he said, oh, please.
Oh, gee.
Maybe he likes that.
Her name was Kate.
Oh, Kate.
Manly.
I'm sorry, Kate, but you're dead.
It's a manly
and the
lady.
In one dimension, you have died. But, oh, hey, we got the silencer, so now nobody can ever hear our gunshots ever, no matter how close we are. It's just pew! No, but when I held that guy up in Twin Snakes, he dropped a dog tag, which are collectibles. In MGS2, if you picked up a whole lot of dog tags throughout the difficulties, you could unlock stuff. In Twin Snakes, they serve no purpose. You get nothing for collecting the dog tags.
Sense of satisfaction.
Not really. Because there's like, each difficulty has different dog tags. So it's like you gotta go through every difficulty and play the game to just get different names from dog tags from soldiers that might be in the same place.
That's really fruitless sounding.
I know. At least in MGS2 you got like wigs and sunglasses and stuff. Cardboard box!
The game has officially started. We have a box. Yes!
Now, I want to leave. I want to go outside this room with the box, but of course I can't. I can't have the box on me and hold the card in my hand at the same time, so I'm sorry.
Snake is not a multitasking kind of guy.
Look, I have a left hand and a right hand, alright? This cardboard box is big and requires both. There's little handles on the inside of the box and he holds on to them while he's running. I hate this guy. The first time I played this game, I got caught by this guy a lot.
That was close.
I know, I was like an inch away, so instead of, you know, snapping his neck, I just kind of like did a weird little jig for a second there. Very indecisive jig. It's like, I'm not gonna dance, never mind. Hey, mind detector, we need this. Something that...
What are you doing there?
Was... I was looking under the desk. I was trying to see if there were snake snacks underneath the desk. Alright.
Sneak the snake snacks.
Sneak the snake snacks. Okay, box time. One thing that was like... When they were making the first MGS, one of the things they wanted to do was like, you know, have attention to detail. So like one of their things in their like design documents for the game was literally every single office desk has to be different.
Huh.
So, like, those desks in there have, like, slightly different textures on them. Like, one of them has pencils, and one of them has paper.
Wow. That's personalized.
I'm sure this
backstory...
You tell
the guy who worked here liked pencils a little bit more than paper.
Yeah. Whoosh.
Whoosh. That airlock is set with infrared sensors. You probably can't see them with your naked eyes.
Yep.
But there are infrared beams
my naked eyes.
Naked snake
eyes. Better put some pants on these eyes. Maybe they'll be able to see them.
Somehow you've got to get through without. Apparently they're just abs, though. So.
Oh God. I forgot that his eyelids are abs. So he doesn't close his eyes. He doesn't blink. He flexes his eyeballs instead. So there's a couple ways to see the lasers. Also, the thermal goggles and twin snakes really hurt.
Whoa.
Yeah. In twin snakes, you can see the lasers through thermal goggles or smoking, or you can shoot the fire extinguisher.
I didn't know that.
I know, that was a thing they carried over from MGS2. And there's also control units right there that you can shoot, and
what?
It just turns the laser off. Yeah.
I died so many times for no reason. Because of the depth perception problems in here.
Yeah,
You have no idea where those lasers are!
You have to look at, like, the edge where they're coming out of the wall. That's the only way you can tell which laser is which.
Or if it's going in front of you or behind you.
Yeah.
That's how I did it.
Yeah.
Because I didn't even think to look at the wall. That's how bad I am at this game. I don't even have common sense.
Oh, no. I'm sorry.
It's a condition. Tracks.
It's not a boss arena.
It's not... Ominous.
Cell phone.
Snake, be careful.
Dr.
There are claymore mines around there. Use a mine detector. Who are you? Just call me Deep Throat.
I heard about you on the bathroom wall too.
Never mind about that. You're not using burst transmission. Are you nearby?
I really want to know what burst transmission is.
Read the bathroom wall more. Talk about all this sort of kinky stuff.
I guess I'm going to have to go back and read that, find out what burst transmission is. Maybe it's sexy. You don't know. Burst might be able to imply something. So there are mines here. So we're going to use our mine detector.
Wow, they're looking right at you.
And yeah, if you just run straight, he calls you like right when you're about to step on one. It's a good thing you stop immediately when somebody calls you on your cell phone.
Did you just pick up that claymore with your ass cheeks?
Yeah. So yeah, for some reason claymores don't blow up when you crawl on them. And you can actually pick them up and take them for yourself.
With your ass.
Well, yeah. Well, he might be picking them with his feet. But then again, maybe his butt is just so toned that he can, like, grab them and, like, throw them into his pocket.
We've already discussed the importance of butts in Metal Gear games, so I think it's pretty obvious what the canon answer to this is.
The butts are doing the everything behind the scenes. I feel bad about myself.
I fucking hate you. I'm never commentating again.
No!
Leaving.
No! Come back! It wasn't even intentional. I was just supposed to be like, plot twist, the butts are doing everything. But
the butts are pulling the strings. Buppet masters. I hate everything.
Yeah.
That's right. You belong on the ground.
When I was a kid playing this, I used to think that the names in parentheses were their real names.
Oh.
Like Vulcan Raven's real name before he became Vulcan Raven got a really cool name was Chuck. So I was like, stop blowing me up, Chuck.
Dang it, Chuck.
He doesn't look like a Chuck.
Let's go shoot a tank with our tiny pistol. Ouch. Maybe not.
I got him! Let me come out of the tank and laugh at him.
Thumbs down.
Okay, guys, I did it. Go back to shooting him.
Wait. I got a totally sick burn. Hold on, I'm gonna get out and I'm gonna laugh at him. So I don't know how to beat this tank. Let's call people for advice. Let's call Campbell. I'm sure he knows stuff about tanks.
Snake, look out for that tank's main gun. It'll pulverize.
Thanks.
I didn't. Oh, that's why.
Ask Natasha. She knows everything there is to know about weapon systems.
Who?
Oh! Okay. Yeah, Nastasha's another part of the support team that you don't really ever have to call ever, and she's not in the story that much, but
do you,
call her anyways.
Know about her if you don't call Campbell now?
I don't know.
Well, hello there.
That's me. You can ask me anything about nukes.
Have I heard about you on bathroom wall too?
Kind of sound like she's hitting on him there. Ask me anything about nukes, Snake.
That M1 tank is equipped with advanced Victronics.
What?
It locks onto a target.
Advanced techno babbles.
Oh, it's got techno babbles. Okay.
Use your chaff.
Oh.
Oh, that's disgusting.
Well, I'm gonna do a gross thing. No. I'm gonna throw some chaff. Look at what Snake's weak underhand to throw. Okay, so using chaff.
His dad never was there to play baseball with him when he was a kid.
Oh. So you can jam his targeting system so you can get close enough, and then he can't use his gun when it's really close to you, so he can only use the machine gun. And then what you want to do is throw grenades up into the tank. And if you land one, like, right on top of the guy, it kills the guy in one shot. But it's a little tricky to do, because, you know, throwing is kind of finicky, because Snake underhands everything like the little girl.
I think they would have honed that skill in spy school, but no.
I know. Just keep being an awful paperboy.
Be a gruff paperboy.
And in Twin Snakes, you can do a couple other different things to the tank. For one, those claymores you picked up, you can use them to blow up the treads. And you blow up a bunch, and it slows down a whole lot. They did make the tank move faster, so it's like actually a threat, and you could actually like get run over by it. Also, you could... Oh, wow.
You can
blew up right in my
hand.
I forgot that's a thing you can do in MGS1 and 2. That's like a technique they use in VR missions. Ouch. I just got ran over by a tank, no big deal.
No problem.
Slipped by through wound. Oh, it landed right in his... Right in his... Is it gonna blow up? Oh, there it goes. Okay. I had to wait for the other explosion. Yeah, they were taking turns there. Also in Twin Snakes, you could just go into first person and shoot the guy in the face.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. The boss fight's kind of a joke in Twin Snakes. Not that it's particularly hard in this one, either. I mean, it's only the second fight, so...
Mm. The boss fights are just one right after another in this game.
Yeah, they are! Like, almost every single video in this LP for a while is gonna have a boss fight. I forgot how quick they come.
It's like every other room is a boss room.
Yeah, pretty much story room, like two sneaking rooms, boss fight.
Are you gonna throw it?
Snake, it's been more than 4 seconds. That grenade would have blown up by now.
I love Twin Snakes. I love it. How there should have been some dubs.
Look, he flew like a good 20 feet at least. What an asshole.
And you broke his nose.
I love that he sizzles when he hits the snow. Snake, did you really have to be such an asshole and just deck him in the face? He was already on fire.
You could have just asked him, hey, can I borrow that card key? Please. I mean, you're on fire, but I mean, can you just reach in your pocket and give me that?
Like, that guy was reaching for help. You decked him, and he died. He died, Snake.
We'll play with him a little longer. You would be wise not to underestimate.
Every time it switches back to PS1, I think, like, I don't have my glasses on or something.
Oh god, my vision. God, this guy's voice actor. He's just a robot.
It's like a Native American robot. Navajo-bot.
I hear he took your hand as well as your dignity. Beep boop, my gimmick is birds. Also, I am not white. That's my other gimmick.
Also, my name is Chuck. Or is it?
Who knows?
He always sounds so flirty, Liquid Snake. Don't kill him yet.
Don't kill him yet.
Oh, don't you dare. So why, there's no snakes in Alaska, but why are there ravens in Alaska?
I don't know. Well, ravens can fly, alright? It's okay.
Are there actually ravens in Alaska?
I don't know. I don't think so. Well, hey, let's save and call Mei Ling. But I did a boo-boo, and the save message is actually the one from last video, but at least it's in her bad accent voice, so that's something, I guess.
You could have said you did it on purpose.
Well, I did it on purpose.
And they would have been like, oh, thank you for showing us both the bad accent and the good accent version of the exact same dialogue. You're the best, LP or Chip.
I did it on purpose. Look at me. I'm a master editor in videos. Look at it. Look at this. I did it on purpose. It's me. I'm the mastermind.
You're the master butt behind the scenes.
Oh, yeah, boy. Well, see you all later.